Broadcast is now starting. All attendees are in listen-only mode.
हेलो पंकज। हाँ सुनील।
आर यू एबल टू सी माय डेस्कटॉप?
यस 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 यू कैन स्टार्ट द प्रेजेंटेशन एंड यू कैन कंटिन्यू योर सेशन।
ओके ओके फाइन फाइन थैंक यू। सो एज वी आर हैविंग टुडेज लेक्चर ऑन यूनिट नंबर 6 फॉर क्लाउड सर्विसेज एंड एप्लीकेशंस, राइट? सो ऑलरेडी आई हैव प्रिपेयर्ड सम वीडियोस ऑन यूनिट नंबर 4, राइट? So those are uploaded on YouTube and a link is also shared with you, right? So today we'll see the unit number 6, that is a completely based on AWS Cloud Architect, right? So let me start. So this is a presentation, right? So the unit name is Architecting for the Cloud, that is the best practices. So how you are going to use a AWS services for your applications, right? So you will see here the components that are involved in AWS cloud for implementing the application. So that part we will see here. We'll see some benefits of a cloud computing with respect to the AWS cloud, right? So these parts are the syllabus of the unit number 6. So it's a very important part, because in an exam around 30 marks questions will be there on this unit, because it's very important. A small questions will be there. So you need to architect your applications based on the services, which services you will use it and how you will use these services for it in a short description, right? So this is actually the main agenda of this lecture, right? So I think around 59 students are there, 57. Can anyone post that whether all of you are audible and the screen whatever shared, is that it's properly? Just comment in the chat section. There is a chat section, right? So you just, because I will continue then.
You can expand the question window. Students are posting the message. Yes, it's properly visible and audible.
Okay, okay, fine, fine. Okay, so now, so we'll come to this now. So the first topic that in this unit we are going to study is what are the business benefits of a cloud computing with respect to our AWS cloud, right? So with respect to AWS cloud, you need to answer it, because you need to take care mind in AWS what kind of the services it provides and how it is helpful for my business, right? So now the first feature that you are having a almost zero upfront infrastructure investment, right? So you, as all of you know, that you have in a practical, you have created a EC2 instance, you have created a RDS instance, so there is no need of hardware requirement at your site, right? So whatever the hardware site that you are going to use by the AWS cloud, right? So basically it provides us the, if you have built a large scale system, it may cost a fortune to invest in a real estate, right? So you need to invest many your amount in your hardware parts, racks, servers, routers, backup powers and supplies if you are doing your own, right? So but in AWS cloud this is not required. What you have to do is that you have to just go to your that web browser, AWS console, and based on that you will use the services. So all other maintenance part, operation part, physical security part, hardware related any maintenance part, so all these things will be handled by what, my AWS. So that's why this is the first business benefit of cloud computing, right? So almost zero upfront infrastructure in a investment, right? So now coming toward the second topic, that we are having a just in time infrastructure. It's very important, just in time. The just in time infrastructure is nothing but is that you are going to get the infrastructure very quickly, right? So earlier there was a rack space, so which was providing us the servers for about three months. Okay, so if we give the demands for applications for deployment of applications into the hardware, so around 3 months are required minimum. But now on demand, you are getting within a 10 second or within a 1 minute, you are going to get these infrastructures, right? So all these infrastructures came into a just in time infrastructures, right? So I will just read it. In the past, if your application becomes so popular and your system or your infrastructure did not scale, you become a victim of your own success. So another example that I will give is that, let us say you are deploying your application and it needs a scaling, right? So initially you know that this application requires 2 GB of RAM, right? So 500 GB of hard disk, right? So afterward, what will happen is that the number of users are incremented, the number of users are more, then you need obviously high computing power. So the solution is that you are going to replace some RAMs, right? So you will replace the virtual CPU or you will buy the new servers, right? So this was a totally time consuming, right? So now what AWS cloud is giving is that it will give you the feature of auto scaling. Auto scaling is nothing but is that automatically based on the consumer or customer's request, it will scale, right? So that's why it is called as a feature just in time infrastructure, right? So in very shortly, we are getting these resources, right? Now the third business benefit is what? More efficient resource utilization, right? So more efficient resource utilization means what? So here there is very less work for a system administrator, right? So system administrator usually worry about the hardware. So what kind of the hardware will require for the deployment of applications, right? So they have to worry about all these things, whether these configurations will be available or not. So how to make a suitable hardware for our applications, right? So it was not an efficient resource utilization for hardware, because many times what was happening is what, they may be having a 50 GB of RAM, but actually that application is not requiring a 50 GB of RAM. So why to waste the 50 GB of RAM for that application? Right, so it was a headache for the system administrator. So but what AWS cloud is giving to give us is that based on your requirement, you can create your EC2 instance. If you are requiring only 2 GB of RAM, you can create a 2 GB. If you require a 3 GB of RAM, you can create using a 3 GB. So more efficient resource utilization, and you will only pay for the amount of the resources that you are using it. So that's why it's a very efficient resource utilization that our AWS cloud is providing, right? Now, coming to the next is what? Usage-based costing, right? So how the costing will be there? So earlier case, what actually we did is that we spent a lot of money for buying the infrastructures. Now we are not buying the infrastructure, we are renting the infrastructure, okay? So we are renting the infrastructure in hourly basis, okay? So that is what on-demand instances, right? So if I select the on-demand instances, then I will pay only for the hour basis, right? So I am using only for 1 hour, then I will pay only for 1 hour. So this is talking about the on-demand instances. Now there is another category, that is what, a reserved instances. So in case of a reserved instances, you are going to pay for 1 year, 2 year or a 3 year. So you will reserve the resources, right? So what benefit actually you will get from by reserving the resources, that you will get a maximum discount, okay? So let us say that if you are paying $1 for 1 hour for one EC2 instance, then this reserved instances will be less than 50%, okay? So a maximum discount will be there. So for which application basically these reserved instances are important? If you know that your application will be continuing for a 1 year, 2 year or a 3 year, so already you are knowing that your applications will continue that, right? So why not to go for this reserved instances then, right? Because it is giving out maximum saving, right? So all the companies are looking for this only. What actually they want is that they want the infrastructure in very less cost, right? So this AWS cloud is providing the usage based costing. Is this clear to us, right? You will save money there, right? Now coming to what? Reduced time to the market, right? So reduced time to market means what? Let us say that there is a new application, there is a new project which require around, let us say that 50 GB of RAM, right? So what you will do is that if you are not having a 50 GB of RAM, you will go to this market, you will buy these servers, you will use these servers, you will all these do, right? So this time will be reduced. You are not going to go to the market, right? So all things will be available there. AWS will provide you all these services over there. Is this clear? So basically, these are what my business benefits of a cloud computing. Is this clear, right? So along with the example I told you about that, what this business benefit of cloud computing mean for AWS, right? So what we'll do is that I will just show you that console. Right, so this is the AWS management console, right? So already we saw the practicals here, right? So let me show first what we'll do, we'll cover it and we'll come to this, right? So now second we'll come to what a technical benefits of cloud computing, right? So what technical benefits means in terms of our applications, right? If my applications need something, right? So is these things are available with the AWS? Is the AWS provide these technical benefits? So what are those technical benefits? We'll see, right? So first technical benefits is automation. Okay, scriptable infrastructure. So scriptable infrastructure means what? You can create a script, you can write a script, okay, for performing some actions, for performing what? Some daily actions. Okay, so now what daily actions are included? What, for the best example is what? Backup. Okay, let us say that you have deployed your database into the AWS cloud and you want to use this database, okay, because it's a very important database for you. So you want to take a daily snapshot. Okay, if you want to take a daily snapshot, so in a AWS console there is an option of taking the snapshots, right? So just I will show you. So see here, this is overall you are having here. So if I go to this RDS, right? So after going to the RDS, it will open its first console page of RDS. RDS stands for what? Relational Database System, right? Here you are going to give the database for your applications, right? So we'll look for this. Okay, now see here, you can see that if I just click on this database, this is a complete dashboard that will look like, right? So here there are no databases are available, right? But you are having these services that you can use it. Okay, so if you see this create database, so there are snapshots are available. So what is a snapshot then? The snapshot is nothing but it's like just like what? A backup of your database. Okay, you are going to store. Why you are going to store? Right, see here, there is a button that is a take snapshot. So every time daily you need to click on this take snapshot for taking the snapshots, right? So how I can save my time, because I want to log into this AWS console, then go to the RDS, then take a snapshot. So obviously this is a very time consuming. So what is the alternative way is that? The alternative way is that I can write a script and this will be automatically. So whenever I run that program, so automatically it will take a snapshot. So there is no need to go to the AWS console, no need to select the database for which database I want to take a snapshot. So automatically by running that script, you will automatically that snapshot will be taken and snapshot will come here, right? So this will save our time. So this is a automation. So my AWS is providing a automation. It is providing us. So the best example, so these automation scripting languages, they are providing a Java also, they are providing Python. So using a Python also you can write a script there, right? So it can interact with your AWS environment, AWS hardware environment. Is this clear, right? So that is what a first feature, automations, right? Now coming to what a second feature is, what auto scaling, right? Now what is the auto scaling? The word itself indicates auto scaling means what? You can scale your application based on the demands. You can scale up and you can scale down, right? Based on the demands of the user. So let us give me an example is that You have deployed a web application, let us say social networking website, and this social networking website requires, okay, so let us say that in this month you have deployed that applications and initially there are 50 users, right? So your websites becomes very famous, so users got increased from 50 to thousands, right? But you have deployed this web application on only 2 GB of RAM. So if the requests are increasing, obviously it will be degrading the performance. The genuine users or the people accessing, they may experience some delay while accessing these applications, right? So you don't want that because it's your business, right? So you want such feature should be there with the there should be at the AWS, so that automatically based on the request it should scale. Okay, so that is what a auto scaling features, right? So now coming to what proactive scaling. So proactive scaling means what? Based on your demand with proper planning, means you will do some planning that if these things happen and based on that it should scale it. Okay, so if these are happening, if the my CPU utilization is going more than 70%, then automatically a new instance should be there, right? So like this, you should have the proactive scaling also, right? So it will cover the scale up also and scale down also, right? So let us say that if your CPU utilization is very less than 20%, right? So why to make active for that EC2 instance, we can have the another EC2 instance that we can use it for fully, right? So this is what a proactive scaling. Now next is what? More efficient development life cycle, right? So here you are going to code applications. You will develop, that is a testing, that is a development phase. So you are developing the applications, you can test the applications, and you can production. So basically in a company there are these environments are available, right? So one is a development environment, okay, then a production testing environment where you are going to test your application, and the last one is what? Production means you are deploying your applications, now the real consumers are going to use it, right? So all these facilities are available with the AWS. So that feature is provided by CI/CD. So that CI/CD is nothing but what? A continuous integration and continuous delivery, right? So you are working on a product, okay, that is in a development phase, right? So automatically whenever you push your code into that, so it will automatically test the things, okay, because we need to specify there what needs to be tested there, right? So that is a testing phase, and automatically it will be deployed into what the third one, that is a production environment, right? So this is very important, right? Now improved testability, right? So this is basically most of the companies are using for testing their applications, right? So what kind of the applications they are testing? Let us say that if they are having some they have developed a game, right? And if they want to check that whether it will work for a 2 GB of RAM, so minimum requirement, to find out the minimum requirement, right? So for that they are going to use the test the things, how the module will work for 2 GB of RAM, for 2 virtual CPUs, for 1 GB of RAM, right? So they are going to test the things for your applications, right? Now disaster recovery and business continuity, it's very important. Disaster recovery is nothing but is that if something disaster happens, if there is any problem happens, right? So how your AWS is overcoming these problems, okay? So now let me tell you that AWS providing a replica here, AWS providing a feature of backup, and AWS providing a feature of what? A snapshot, right? So basically these are basically used for disaster recovery. So let us say that if I am taking a backup, okay, so that backup will be stored somewhere, so if some disaster happens, then I can take that backup, and based on that backup I will again create a EC2 instance. So I will get what? Only very short amount of data, maybe lost, right? So because it's totally depend on our configurations, right? So daily after 5 minutes or so you can take a backup. After 5 minutes you can take a backup. Now basically these backups are incremental. So incremental means what? So if I am taking the backup today morning at a 9 o'clock, so it will take 9 up to the 9. Then if I am again taking the backup at 9:05 a.m. so it will take only those 5 minutes backup. So all other backup will be already available. So this is what an incremental backup, right? So now overflow, right? So overflow the traffic of the cloud with a few clicks, effective load balancing tactics, right? So this overflow concept is that, let us say that if you are having an application and that application is going to be let us say the social networking website, you are having a 4 EC2 instances and you want to distribute the request. So here comes out a load balancing, right? So my AWS is also providing the load balancer. So that's why these are what a technical benefits of a cloud computing that our AWS is providing us, and we can use it for our application. So that's why many companies are moving toward this AWS cloud. So currently I told you that 34% of shares are there with this AWS cloud, right? So now I will come toward the next now. So understanding the Amazon Web Service Cloud, it's very important understanding. So you need to know about these services, what are available. So this is a picture is available, so you just see the, and based on this picture we will see these things, right? Now see here, here on top of this there is a your applications, right? Here is a your application means what, you have deployed your applications there. So you, these applications can use these services, okay? And below you are having these physical infrastructures, right? So you will start with this base, okay? Now obviously hardware is required. If you want to deploy something, the hardware is required. So where actually these hardwares are located, okay? So basically these AWS hardwares are located in a geographical regions, okay? So those are called as what, a regions, right? So inside the region there are number of availability zones, okay? And inside that availability zone there are n number of edge locations around the world, right? So I will show you with the practical, right? So see here, if I go to this, so just click on it, so you will see these all are regions, okay? These all are regions available all over. You will see that US East, this is North Virginia, right? US East, then US East 1. So there is US East dash 1, US East dash 2. So here is the Asia Pacific Mumbai. So all these are what? A regions. So inside that region, there are multiple availability zones. Okay. So while creating a EC2 service, you saw that there. These are the so basically there are 3 availability zones. Okay. And those are represented US East 1A. US East 1B and US East 1C. So it is represented like this. So availability zones are inside the regions, okay? And there is one more term is what, edge location. So these edge locations are across the world, okay? So basically these edge locations are used for speed up, okay? For speed up, right? So basically this works as what, catching the contents, okay? Catching the contents. So let us say that if I give the example is that you have deployed your application in a Mumbai, okay? So your application is there in a Mumbai, and let us say that one customer is accessing your applications from the America, yes or no, right? So what is the actually use case for that American customer? That American customer is going to visit your applications which is basically deployed in a Mumbai, right? So you see that from the request is originating from the America and it will come toward the India, Mumbai, right? So in between there are number of hops are available because it has to pass through the internet, okay? Obviously it requires some time. Now what these edge locations are doing is that, so edge locations are available across the globe, okay? So near to the America there might be some edge locations, okay, where if the previous customer has accessed in same application, then the catching will happen at that edge location. So the new customer will get that request from that edge location only. So for a new customer, there is no need to go to India, to the Mumbai, right? So it will only get this content from what, that edge locations, right? So these edge locations are basically, these are acting as like what, a caching, right? Now this is also having a TTL, right? So you might be aware about this TTL, time to live, right? So let us say that you have changed your application, so that has to be reflected at those edge locations, right? So this is a TTL, right? So within the TTL, so they are specifying the TTL, let us say 1 day, yeah, 2 day, yeah, 1 hour, right? So based on that, TTL will be there. So based on that, costing will be there, right? So you understood this thing now, first part, right? So the first, the lowest part, that is what, physical infrastructure, where actually this physical infrastructure are located. So this physical infrastructure are located in a regions. Inside these regions, there are availability zone. Those are called as a data centers. Okay. And also we are having a different edge locations available across the world. Right. Now coming to what you are going to deploy your applications, then you require to store some media content. You want to store your images. You want to store your videos. Let us say that if your application is requiring these things, right? So in every application, in every web applications, images are there. If you want to store these images there, if you want to store these videos, then where I can store these things? So I can store all these things in Amazon S3, right? So Amazon S3 is a service where we can store our images, videos, text files, and everything. We can store everything over there, right? So not only these images and videos, right? We can store everything on Amazon S3. So these, in Amazon S3, these things are stored under the bucket. There is a concept of bucket. So the bucket is very similar to like a folder, right? So inside that folder, we can have a many object. So objects are nothing but what actually you are storing. If you are storing that image, so that image is an object. If you are storing a text file, that text file is an object, right? So this will be there under that bucket, right? And for this Amazon S3, already I shared a one YouTube video that I have prepared it, that how to create a S3 bucket and how to upload the objects into it, right? So you can look for this, because for your applications deployment development, you will require these things. Is this clear to all, right? Now coming toward the next import is what, you are having a Amazon EC2 instances. Just I have talked about EC2 instances, right? So what is the purpose of EC2 instances? Firstly, what is the EC2? The EC2 is indicating Elastic Compute Cloud, right? So basically these are providing a virtual server for us, right? Virtual server for deploying our applications, right? Now there are different types of instances available. I think already I have given you the information about it. On demand, if I want on demand, means I require now and I require only for a short period of time. I require only 1 day, 2 day, 4 day, 1 month, right? So based on that, I will select the on demand. Right now, reserved instance is what? No, I require these EC2 instances for 3 years. Yes or no? Right, I know for my application it requires 3 years. So why I can go for a reserved instances? Because I am going to get a maximum discount there. Right now, the spot instances. So what is actually this spot instances? So these spot instances will give the informations, will provide us the EC2 instance based on the spots. Means here it's just like what, a bidding, right? So in an IPL auction, in IPL auction we bid for a place, right? So similar to that only here, right? You are bidding things, right? You will say that I will pay only $0.006 for this EC2 instance. You will bid for that. If the current bidding price is lower than whatever your price that you have bid, right? So obviously you will get that EC2 instance. If it is more than that, you will not get that one. So what is actually the spot instance? So spot instance is very useful, is what, wherever very a short workload is there. Okay, so you want to work only for 1 day, right? So it will be very good because you will get a maximum discount. So up to the 90% discount you will get from these spot instances over these on-demand instances, right? So you need to, you are a cloud architect. You are a cloud architect means what? You are going to tell what kind of the service you will use for your applications. It's your duty to tell, right? So you should know about these things, that how I can use this EC2 instances, right? So we have talked about this. I think we'll just wait for it and we can have some questionnaires. If anyone have questionnaires, then please raise hand so that I can answer you for your queries. Any queries, please, questions. Okay. I think you are knowing that there is a hand raise. Okay. In a mobile app, there is a hand raise option. So by using this hand raise, you can ask me any questions there. Any questions, please ask me. I will just wait for 2 to 3 minutes. Any questions, please? Vaibhav. Okay. So Vaibhav is having a questions. He has hand raised, right? So I am doing a unmute for you, right? So Vaibhav, please talk your question. Please ask your question. Vaibhav. Vaibhav.
Sir, I haven't raised my hand.
It's there, it's looking. Okay, already. Anyone have questions? Anyone have questions? Vikas, a hand raise is there for Vikas also, right? Okay. I think no questions here. Yes, I think Shyam has asked one question, right? So can we use a EBS instead of S3, right? So let us understand difference between the EBS and S3, right? So EBS is elastic block store, right? And S3 is a simple storage service, right? So EBS is basically acting as like a hard drive, right? So we are having a laptop desktop machine, and along with this desktop machine we are having a hard drive. So EBS is acting like what? A hard drive. It's a block store, right? So S3 is a object store, right? So if you want to store some text file, so these S3 can't be attached to your EC2 instance, okay? But this EBS can be attached to what? EC2 instance, right? So if you are working for a EC2 instance, if you are having your virtual servers, then you can use this virtual servers, and you need a storage, then that time you can attach the EBS to this your EC2, right? Instead of S3. Is this clear to all, right? So for VC2, for EC2 communications, for EC2 attachment, you are going to use a EBS, right? So in, what you will do in S3 then? Then you will store S3 in images, videos, okay? If you want to securely store some files, right? So also S3 is used for what? Hosting the web application also. Is this clear, right? So you can use that one. So I think answer is clear, right? So now one more question I asked. So for our project, we have to use ABS, right? Yes. If you are using, you are deploying, you are storing your files over there. Now see here how your projects will look like, right? Now, basically your project require EC2 instances. Now why these EC2 instances are required? Because you are going to have a Apache server over there. You will deploy your applications. Your code will be reside there. Is this clear, right? Now in your project, you are having some what you say is that images. Let us say that you are, because in every project we are using images, right? Now those images will be stored in a S3. Those images will be stored in a S3, and that S3 link will be given to your application so that it will use that S3, right? So obviously if you are using a EC2 instance, you have to use a EBS also. So in EBS, what you will store in EBS, automatically your files will be stored there. Okay. So what files will be stored? Your index.html, yeah, any other pages will be stored there. And inside that coding index.html, if you are using any images, so that images need not to be stored on that EBS. Okay. So that should be stored on S3. Right. Now you may be asking a question is that In EBS also we can store, right? Yes, you can store it, no issue. But here we are going to use a S3. So how the S3 can be useful for our project? So then you may have a question is that why need to store in a S3? Because S3 is a different component. So S3 is a different component, so that in S3 if I store these images, right? So if my code or application is hacked, okay, something has happened, right? So then that images will be securely stored over there. So this is actually the purpose that people are using the S3 for storing the images and videos, and that link will be given to your applications, right? I think hope my answer will be clear. So any other questions? Any questions? Okay, so I am deleting the questions here. So no other questions, right? So we'll move to the next part now. So we'll come to this. So we saw this EC2. Now see here EC2, you are having a EBS volumes here. So whenever you are using a EC2 instances, so you have to use a EBS block store, where actually your OS is stored. In EBS, OS is stored. In EBS, your application is stored, right? So your application is deployed over there, right? So you can use a Amazon S3 where you are going to store your images or videos, right? So this will be available, right? Now this EC2 will also come along with auto scaling. We talked about this auto scaling. So what is the auto scaling is what? This auto scaling will give us the feature is that based on our user application, based on the record, it will scale automatically, scale up and scale down also, right? So elastic load balancer, right? So what is this elastic load balancer? Let us say if you are having a 4 EC2 instances, and these 4 EC2 instances are working for a same applications, okay? The same application is deployed there, so it is just like a web server, okay? Now if you want to distribute the traffic, if you want to distribute the request, so obviously you use a load balancer. So that load balancer feature will be available with the AWS, right? So you may be having a question is that, sir, I can develop my own load balancer. Yes, you can develop your own load balancer, but what will happen is what? The efforts are required, and that load balancer also should auto scale based on the request. Let us say that if you are using a load balancer and it is only serving for 1000 requests, okay, it can handle the 1000 requests, then what is the use of this load balancer? So you should have the auto scaling load balancer also. Based on the request, it should scale up and scale down, okay? Now coming to the next is what, a cloud watch. Now what is this cloud watch functions, right? So basically this cloud watch function is used, or this service is used, for a monitoring purpose. Monitoring is nothing but if you want to monitor your applications, right? Now see here, your application is running, okay? Now see here, you are running your applications, right? Let us say that you are having your own company, you have deployed the applications, right? And it's running, and what happens is that at a night, because of some problems, your instances got stopped, yes or no? But you are not knowing that instances got stopped, right? So how you will know about that your instances got stopped? You will get a complaints from the customers. The customer says that your instances stop, okay, we are not getting a service from your application. So this thing you will get, this information you will get from your customer. So it's very bad. Yes or no, right? So you should know. So for that you are going to deploy a CloudWatch. So what CloudWatch will do is that CloudWatch will monitor your infrastructure, monitor your resources, monitor your RDS instance, monitor your EC2 instance, and automatically it will notify you. Okay, so let us say that at 1 p.m. at night, 1 p.m. okay, your EC2 instance stopped. So automatically this CloudWatch will send you a mail that your EC2 instance has stopped. So what you will do, okay? So you will go and you will see that, is there any problem with my EC2 instance? Is there any problem with my application? You will do these things and you will recover, okay? So you will not get a complaint from the customer. You will solve that request, okay? You will solve that problem because of what, this CloudWatch, because CloudWatch is monitoring your applications, right? So before getting a complaint from the customers, you can modify your applications, you can modify EC2 instance, and it will be workable. Is this clear to us? So for that, the CloudWatch is used for monitoring purpose, right? Now you are having a Amazon SQS. So what is this SQS stands for? SQS is standing for simple queue service. SQS standing for what? Simple queue service. Now where actually it is used? So let me tell the application. Let us say that the Amazon, right? So Amazon is the application, that Amazon website where you get a delivery of your products, right? So how this Amazon web application, basically this Amazon website uses this Amazon SQS functionalities, right? So how it is, let us say that you are purchase something, you did a payment also, right? So this will go to what? A particular vendor. This information will go to what? Particular vendor. Now before going to the particular vendor, you want to decouple your application. If you want to decouple your application, means you want to split up your applications, right? So split up means what? The Amazon AWS will be one component where you will do the buying service. Okay, so and this will be decoupled from shipping service. So basically the shipping is going to happen from that vendor side. Yes or no? So shipping is a different service and buying the service is a different module, right? So decouple these two components, right? So what is the problem? Now say in Amazon AWS we are getting a lot number of orders. Okay, so if we are not decoupling these things, then what will happen is that, so whatever the buying service will produce so many results, okay, and shipping service is unable to handle these requests. So some data may be lost. Yes or no? Some data may be lost, and this is not good for your business. So that's why you are going to sort Amazon SQS, simple queue service. So this is very similar to like what a producer and consumer. Producer is producing so many things, okay, so many requests, right? But whether the consumer is able to accept all these requests, if the consumer is not able to accept all these requests, then what will happen is that some request will be lost, right? So this is not good for your, so you want to decouple. So what SQS is doing is that SQS is storing your messages, okay, in between, so that consumer will process these messages, okay, in a one day, right? So in a 2 day, right? So based on that it will process the message, so there will be no data lost. Is this clear? So this is actually decoupling purpose, right? Now Amazon SNS topic, right? So SNS is what? Simple notification service. It's very important, right? I given you the example of CloudWatch, right? So I told you that the CloudWatch will send you the mail. So how the CloudWatch will send? The CloudWatch will only monitor the things and it will send these informations. CloudWatch will send this information to the SNS and SNS will send these informations to what? Those subscribers. Okay, the subscribers means what? Let us say manager, that developer, right? So it will send a mail to all those. Okay, so CloudWatch is unable to send a mail, but CloudWatch will take help of this SNS, and based on that SNS it will notify to their subscribers. Okay, so let us say that the manager is a subscriber, that developer is a subscriber, tester is a subscriber, so it will send these informations to all. Is this clear? So this is a SNS service, simple notification service, right? Now coming towards here, Amazon Simple DB, right? So basically this Amazon Simple DB is what? Databases, right? So we are going to use a databases for domains, right? We can have a root 53, right? We can have our hosted zone, right? Where I can create, I can take a domains, and based on the domains I can deploy my applications, I can do the LIs and all these things, right? So use for that purposes. Now Amazon RDS is very important for your database purposes, right? So and come to the next is what? Amazon Private Cloud. So what is this Amazon Private Cloud is going to do is that, so this is going to give us the information about our own organizations, or this will only allow to install or create the instances on our organizations, for our organization. Nobody others can access to it, right? So for example is that if you want to go for an application, and in that applications you require a two database server, and these two database servers should not be exposed to all. right? It should not be exposed to internet. It should not be accessed to the all the customers, right? So how it could be possible? So it could be possible using what? Amazon VPC, virtual private cloud, right? So you can create your own private cloud. You can provide private instances in this defined area. There is a network is available, so everything is available, and inside that only you do it, so that specifically I can use it for my organization and I can completely configure these things, right? So this is actually the motto behind what this virtual private cloud, creating our own private cloud in AWS. Now see here, this is different than that private cloud, right? So this Amazon private cloud is that you are going to create your own private cloud in AWS, not in your organization. You will create in AWS this thing. This is clear to all, right? So this is overall talking about. Now this is a Amazon cloud front, right? It's very important. So this Amazon cloud front is basically, it's a content delivery network, CDN, right? So where it is going to, so basically this cloud front service is also caching service, and which is going to use the edge locations. It is going to use what? Edge locations that earlier talked about. Edge locations is used basically for catching content. So that is nothing but what? This Amazon cloud front. So this Amazon cloud front is making accessible these edge locations to all other, so that you can use this catching content. So there is no need to go from America to the India every time. Okay. So if one consumer is already access that web application, then it will be cached into the America edge locations cloud from there, and you can use the. So this service is provided by what? By this Amazon cloud front, right? So all about these services are mentioned here in theoretical. You can read all these services, right? So this is what you are understand the services which are available there, right? So you are having the IAM service, right? So why, what is the purpose of using the IAM services? What IAM basically used for? What? Managing the users, okay? Management of your users, right? What this user is going to do these things, right? So this is about the today's part. So I'm having a 10 minutes now, so I can address your questions. So please, if you are having a questions, then please ask me the questions, right? So either you can ask from the question side, or if you want to raise your hand, then you can raise your hand also, right? We are having a 10 minutes time, so please raise your hand or please ask the questions. Yes, Rohit has asked questions. Sir, one, what date you are going to review the projects, right? So I will inform this informations. I will give this informations on WhatsApp, right? So probably in the next week I am planning, right? So in next week, in first week of April, okay, in first week of April, I am planning it. Okay, so what I will do is that I will give the 2nd April. So in the 2nd week of April, so from 6 to 10, so in between 6 to 10 I can review your project. So please complete this task. Already I have given you the information is that you just already, I think many of you have created a Skype group. So please create a Skype group and add me into that group, right? So whenever that date is, you can present myself. And if you are having any problem in EC2, in RDS, in S3, right? So I told you that please install the TeamViewer. Okay, so team using that TeamViewer, I can solve your queries. Okay, so Pranjali has asked the question, that is, what is the function of Amazon Simple DB domain? Okay, so Amazon Simple DB, so basically is a database service other than the RDS. Okay, other than the RDS. So this is not RDS. RDS is a difference and this is a different. So Simple DB service is basically in this DynamoDB service will come. Okay, so what actually this DynamoDB is, what it is giving us the informations about the no SQL database, no SQL type of database, right? So for your projects it's not useful, right? So it's not used for it, right? So now again the question is that, so there is some problem in internet speed, Skype requirements, high speed internet, Okay, so see here, you are three members, four members group. So we have to look for this your internship because all of you are working from home, right? So you just manage it. I'm also having some problem, right? So please manage the internet because this is the only the mode we are going to communicate, right? There is no other mode, right? So please try to it, do it something, right? So get a solutions, right? Get a solutions for our internet. So how I can manage the internet, right? What is expected in the review? Okay, now see here, what is expected in the review is that so basically this review I am going to check that whether you have deployed your application on EC2 instance. Okay, I will check whether you are use the RDS instance. I will check whether you have used a S3. Okay, so I will see all these things, how these are working. I will check it, all these things. I will ask you the questions, how you did it, right? So we have to answer the questions to this, right? So prepare for it, right? So it's just like what, it's like a final one, right? It's a final one. You have completed everything, you have deployed everything, and you are going to show me these things, right? Okay, what are the questions? Can we record the video and send it? Okay, so see here, recording the video and telling the things, right? So it's not an interactive. Okay, it's not an interactive. The project review should be the interactive, right? So this is a mode of where I am going to check whether you are knowing the things or not, right? So you should be, so I told you that this recording the video is not going to help for interactive sessions, right? So how can I ask the question? So this is a problem there, right? So you should please look for this, right? Is it compulsory to use S3 in project? Can we store images in folders and then storing? No, you have to use a S3 there. You have to use a S3 there in project in a compulsory. Okay, so we have to use a S3 because these are the services. So you are going to learn the things, how these services are going to interact with each other. It's very simple. S3 is not, it's a big deal, right? So already I have shared the videos on YouTube. I have given you the link. Please go and refer it, right? It's very simple. It's nothing hard is there, right? You are in every project. I want a S3 issues, right? So basically you require these things. You require a EC2 instance, you require a RDS, and you require S3. So these three should be there compulsory. Okay, so this should be there, right? Okay, now next. My code is directly opening with XAMPP, which includes PHP. I'm not getting your questions. My code is directly opening with XAMPP, which includes PHP. I'm not getting a question, Rupesh. Okay, so you can have a chat. I'm having a problem with STN. So see here, already I sent you a mail already. I have given the information on WhatsApp also, right? So you are going to have a team viewer. I told you that first try to troubleshoot using a Google because you are going to learn it here. If it is not happening, then only you just do it a team viewer. Okay, that will be better for, right? So first do a troubleshooting for this, right? Because unless and until you do the troubleshoot, you will not understand anything. So first try to do a troubleshoot using Google. Try to find the answers. If it is not, if you are, if this a problem is not solvable, then please come with. Then we'll look for it. So any other questions? I think questions over, right? So I'm not getting any new questions here, right? So what you do is that you can ask these questions in in WhatsApp also you can ask me these questions. And I told you that TeamViewer, please try to use a maximum usage, right? Skype, TeamViewer. So you are going to use these things, okay? So these technologies, you will learn how to use these technologies, and this will be very effective, because up to the 14th April, okay, till that announcement, 14th April, so college will not be open, right? So after 14th, we don't know, right? So that's why these things should happen here only, right? So please use it. If you are having an internet problem, then look for how I can solve my internet problem, where I can go, where the internet speed will be there.